Now, I'm going to prove to you that this book that I'm claiming that it's the book of God is for sure the book of God. I'm going to prove it to you in a few minutes. How am I going to prove it to you? Now you're going to see. The written Torah said to the Jews, everything you're going to eat from the ocean, you need to check two things before you eat it. If it has fins and scales, it's kosher. So now, we went fishing somewhere in a lake. We caught a fish. We see that the fish is smooth, it doesn't have any scales. You can scratch it, nothing falls. We know right away this fish is not kosher, but we don't know the fish, we never saw it before. How do we know it's not kosher? It doesn't have scales. The Torah says fins and scales. Two witnesses to say that it's kosher. Fins and scales. If the fish or anything you took out of the ocean doesn't have fins and scales, don't touch it. It's not kosher. Comes the oral Torah, and the oral Torah make a statement. Kol sheyesh lo kaskeset, yesh lo snapir. Every species that you're going to find in the water, every water you're going to search, that have, as you can see here, that have scales, must have fins, guaranteed. How many kinds of fish we know today? More than 40,000 different kinds of fish. Just fish. That's not include the scorpions, the turtles, the snakes, and so many other things that we have in the ocean. Just fish alone, 40,000 different kinds of names. The Torah say, if you picked up the fish and it has scales, don't worry. I guarantee you that it has fins. Kol sheyesh lo kaskeset, scales for sure have fins. Which means, if one person from the time the Torah was given 3,300 years ago, if one person ever would bring a fish or anything from the ocean, a snake, that have scales but doesn't have fins, that's the end of the Torah, the end of Judaism immediately. No more Yom Kippur, no more Pesach, no more Shabbat, no more Tefillin, no more kosher, no more nothing. Why? First mistake in the Torah. If there is a mistake in a book, it cannot be from God. God doesn't make such mistakes. Why? He created all nature. He said in his book, I never made anything in the ocean with scales and without fins. If there is scales, I guarantee you there are fins as well. How much water we have in the world? Who knows? 72% of the world is water. Look at the globe, it's all blue. 3/4 of the world is water. 12 kilometers deep. That's how deep it is. It's much, much deeper. So far, they reached a place in the bottom of the ocean, 12 kilometers, 8 miles. 8 miles from here to Manhattan, or maybe to Queens even. That's how far inside. There are trillions of things that are moving in all the oceans and the lakes and the rivers and the pools and in museums, and scientists are always mixing between all kinds of species. 3,300 years until today, nobody ever found something that has scales and doesn't have fins. And if they do once, we have a big problem in the Torah. Now I want to ask you a question. Is it possible that a human being was able to write such a thing 3,300 years ago? To write such a thing, this is the skills you need to have. First, you have to be able to watch simultaneously 72% of the world, which is, look at the entire globe, is blue. It's all water. 3/4 of the world is water. You have to watch simultaneously the entire species, all of them that moves in all the rivers and all the lakes. And to promise there is not even one in all the lakes and all the rivers and all the pools. Not even one that has scales and doesn't have fins. The writer of the Torah promised you will never find one ever. What human being was able to know such a thing? Who could write such a thing?
only the creator of all the oceans, only the creator of all the fish, only the creator of all the scientists, only the one who controls the future perfectly. Who is he in that case? The creator of the world.